The 10 Most Famous Canvas by Claude Monet. Number 10. Charing Cross Bridge. Circa 1899 to 1904. Painted between 1899 and 1904, Charing Cross Bridge is another series of works Claude Monet created during his stays in London. Like the Waterloo Bridge series, Monet explores how fog, light, and smoke transform the appearance of the bridge and its surroundings. Monet uses soft tones and blurred brushstrokes to depict the bridge and nearby buildings emerging from the fog over the River Thames. Sunlight filtering through the mist creates constantly changing luminous effects that Monet captures with great sensitivity. This series is significant as it deepens Monet's exploration of urban atmosphere and optical effects. Charing Cross Bridge reflects his interest in perception and how environmental conditions alter visual experience. The paintings are valued for their ethereal atmosphere and innovative technique. Monet creates images that are both representative and almost abstract, influencing later artists and enriching the legacy of Impressionism. Number 9. The Houses of Parliament. London series, circa 1899 to 1901. Between 1899 and 1901, Claude Monet painted a series titled The Houses of Parliament, capturing the Palace of Westminster as seen from the River Thames under different light and weather conditions. These paintings focus on the effects of fog, sun, and atmosphere on the Gothic architecture. Monet uses a palette ranging from somber grays and blues to warm oranges and purples, depending on the time of day and climate. The shapes of the Parliament buildings become almost silhouettes, blurred by fog and smog, while light plays a crucial role in creating reflections and shadows in the water. This series is significant because it continues Monet's exploration of how light and atmosphere transform the perception of a single subject. The Houses of Parliament reflects his interest in capturing the intangible and ephemeral, challenging traditional conventions of architectural representation. The paintings are valued for their evocative atmosphere and innovation in Impressionist technique. Monet conveys the essence of London with its changing climate and urban landscape, offering viewers a unique sensory experience. Number 8. Woman with a Parasol. Madame Monet and Her Son, 1875. In Woman with a Parasol, Madame Monet and Her Son, painted in 1875, Claude Monet depicts his wife Camille and their son Jean during an outdoor stroll. The work shows Camille standing on a hill with a parasol, looking at the viewer, while Jean is lower down in the field. Monet uses bright colors and intense light to capture the sunny and windy atmosphere of the day. His brushstrokes are loose and expressive, especially in the grass and clouds, which appear to move with the breeze. The diagonal composition and low viewpoint create a sense of movement and spontaneity. This painting is significant as it exemplifies Monet's Impressionist style at its peak, focusing on natural light and everyday moments. Woman with a Parasol reflects his skill in combining portraiture and landscape, capturing the essence of both person and environment in a single image. The work is appreciated for its elegance and the warmth it conveys of family life. It remains one of Monet's most iconic images and represents his contribution to the development of Impressionism. Number 7. The Gare Saint-Lazare, 1877. Painted in 1877, the Gare Saint-Lazare is part of a series in which Claude Monet depicts the Saint-Lazare train station in Paris. The work shows steam locomotives, platforms, and the glass and iron structure of the station, all enveloped in clouds of steam and smoke. Monet uses a palette of grays, blues, and touches of red and yellow to capture the industrial and dynamic atmosphere of the station. His brushstrokes are energetic, and the steam is represented with blurred areas that add depth and movement. Light filters through the glass roof, creating complex luminous effects. This painting is significant because it reflects Monet's interest in modernity and urban life. The Gare Saint-Lazare shows how Impressionists embraced contemporary themes, exploring new spaces and subjects. The work is also notable for its innovation in the portrayal of light and movement. The painting is valued for its vivid representation of the Industrial Revolution and its impact on society. Monet transforms an everyday scene into a profound artistic exploration, capturing the energy and rhythm of modern life. Number 6. Poppy Field near Argenteuil, 1873. In Poppy Field near Argenteuil, painted in 1873, Claude Monet represents a rural landscape filled with bright red poppies. The work shows two women and two children walking through the field, likely his wife Camille and their son Jean. Monet uses a palette of vivid colors, with intense greens and striking reds, to capture the natural beauty of the landscape. His brushstrokes are loose and fluid, depicting the undulating grass and flowers. The blue sky and white clouds add balance and depth to the composition. This work is significant because it exemplifies the Impressionist focus on natural light and pure colors. Poppy Field near Argenteuil reflects the joy and tranquility of rural life and Monet's connection to his surroundings. The painting is appreciated for its beauty and the peace it conveys. It is one of Monet's most famous works and showcases his ability to capture fleeting moments and the essence of nature. Number 5. Haystacks. Series of Haystacks. Circa 1890 to 1891. Between 1890 and 1891, Claude Monet painted a series known as Haystacks, depicting stacks of hay in the fields near his home in Giverny. Each painting shows the haystacks at different times of day and seasons, exploring how light and weather affect their appearance. Monet uses a wide range of colors and techniques, from warm, golden tones to cool blues and purples. His brushstrokes vary to represent the texture of the hay and atmospheric effects. The composition often centers on the haystack, turning it into an almost abstract object. This series is significant because it deepens Monet's exploration of perception and temporal change. Haystacks demonstrates his commitment to direct observation and his interest in how external factors transform a single subject. The series had a considerable impact on the development of modern art. The paintings are valued for their innovation and the way they challenge traditional conventions. Monet turns a simple object into a complex study of light, color, and form. Number 4. The Water Lily Pond and the Japanese Bridge, 1899. In The Water Lily Pond and the Japanese Bridge, painted in 1899, Claude Monet presents a view of his famous garden in Giverny. The work shows the arched Japanese-style bridge over the pond filled with water lilies, surrounded by lush vegetation. Monet uses rich colors and fluid brushstrokes to capture the serenity and beauty of the garden. Reflections on the water and the interplay of light with leaves and flowers create a tranquil and contemplative atmosphere. The composition balances horizontal and vertical elements, guiding the viewer's gaze across the painting. This painting is significant as it marks the beginning of one of Monet's most iconic series, centered on his water garden. The Water Lily Pond and the Japanese Bridge reflects his fascination with nature and his passion for gardening, turning his surroundings into an endless source of artistic inspiration. The work is appreciated for its harmony and the way it conveys the essence of nature. It is a prime example of Monet's artistic maturity and his contribution to Impressionism. Number 3. The Rouen Cathedral Series, circa 1892-1894. Between 1892 and 1894, Claude Monet painted more than 30 works of the Rouen Cathedral, focusing on the west facade of the building under various lighting and weather conditions. Each painting captures how sunlight transforms the appearance of the Gothic stone architecture. Monet uses a range of palettes, from cool and soft tones to warm and vibrant ones, to represent atmospheric changes. His brushstrokes are dense and textured, reconstructing the cathedral's surface in terms of light and color rather than precise architectural detail. This series is significant as it represents the culmination of Monet's fascination with light and how it affects perception. Rouen Cathedral is a profound study of perception and a challenge to traditional representation conventions. The series influenced later movements, including symbolism and abstract art. The paintings are valued for their innovation and emotional intensity. Monet transforms a well-known monument into a personal, almost spiritual exploration of light and time. Number 2. Water Lilies. Water Lilies Series. Circa 1897-1926. From approximately 1897 until his death in 1926, Claude Monet devoted much of his time to painting his Water Lilies series, inspired by the pond in his garden at Giverny. The series includes around 250 paintings that explore different perspectives, lights, and compositions of the pond and its flowers. Monet uses a vast range of colors and techniques, from delicate brushstrokes to thick applications of paint. Many of the works verge on abstraction, focusing on reflections and water surfaces rather than recognizable elements. The absence of a horizon and traditional perspective creates an immersive and meditative space. This series is significant as it represents the culmination of Monet's career and his major contribution to modern art. Water Lilies explores themes of perception, nature, and sensory experience, anticipating movements like abstract expressionism. The paintings are valued for their beauty and emotional depth. They invite viewers to immerse themselves in contemplation, experiencing nature directly and personally. Number 1. Impression, Sunrise. 1872. Painted in 1872, Impression, Sunrise, is perhaps Claude Monet's most famous work and the one that gave its name to the Impressionist movement. The painting depicts the port of Le Havre at dawn, with ships and cranes faintly visible through the morning mist, and a bright orange sun rising in the sky. Monet uses quick, loose brushstrokes and a limited palette to capture the fleeting impression of the scene. The colors are soft and blurred, except for the sun and its reflection on the water, which stand out vibrantly. The composition is simple yet effective, focusing on light and atmosphere. This work is significant because it challenged the artistic conventions of its time and became a manifesto for Impressionism. Impression, Sunrise, emphasizes subjective perception and direct experience, prioritizing visual sensation over exact detail. The painting is cherished for its innovation and historical impact. It represents a turning point in modern art, symbolizing artistic freedom and the exploration of new ways to see the world. Thank you for watching our video. Subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Give it a like, comment your thoughts, and share this video with your friends and family.